I always wanted to move to New York because that was where all of the opportunities was. But I was like, how am I going to get out of this small city? I didn't have the money. I didn't know anybody in New York. I was like, you know, everybody's like, oh, you'll never make it. You're going to be a small fish in a big pond. You know, you're going to be right back. You're going to be a failure. You know, my mother was back in my life at this time, and my own mother said, oh, there's younger, prettier girls than you in New York. You'll be right back. That hurt, having your own mother not believing in you. It's terrible. But I didn't let that stop me. I said, you know what? I'm tuning out all the hate, all the negativity, and I kept going. So when I turned 29, I packed my things, got rid of my home. I owned my own clothing store. I sold my store because that just wasn't my dream. I kept my dream in my heart, which was to be on that screen since I was little. I kept that, you know, always in the back of my head that I'm going to do this. I'm going to make it. I packed my stuff. In the middle of wintertime, I came to New York. I only knew two people, and I started my whole life over. I started taking classes, workshops in the city, at NYU, at the Tisch School for the Arts, and just learning as much as I could about acting. I went in all the auditions that I could take. I went to all the model castings. I got signed to a lot of major brands for modeling and stuff. But I knew I still wanted to be on that screen. Like, that was my goal since I was in sixth grade. And I said, nothing's going to stop me. I wasn't taking no for an answer, guys. So I just kept on going. I had a friend of a friend that knew somebody in production for Love & Hip Hop in the Atlanta cast. And they made a phone call. And I got all dressed up. I took my little dog, Marge Tiffany, who you probably saw on the show with me, the little chihuahua, so cute. She's an actress too now. And we went into Mona Scott Young, who's the lady that owns the show, wonderful woman. And I went in there for my first audition. I was so nervous. And, you know, I had to go on camera for like 3 hours and just talk about my whole life, the good, the bad, everything. And they really liked me. And I got a call back, so the rest is history. And now that, me being on VH1 has led to me doing so many other things. When I left Love & Hip Hop last year, I got on another show on Channel 9, produced by Ed Lover. I was on there with Mr. Cheeks, Tretch. It was a scripted comedy. So, you know, I'm doing a bunch of other television work now and auditioning for movies. But, you know, my whole story is basically I never gave up. And that goes to say, and I don't want to sound cliche, because I'm sure you kids hear it all the time, and it sounds corny, oh, don't give up. Don't give up. It really can happen for you. I really never thought things were going to ever really come through because I had so many disappointments. But it happened, and I'm here now, and I'm living my dreams when everybody, even like I said, my own mother told me I wasn't going to. And I made it happen because I didn't listen to that negativity. And you guys got it bad nowadays with the social media, all the haters, people just, you know, making fake pages, being negative. Please don't listen to any of that, because I get it every day being in the public eye. People come at me all day. I block about 50 people a day on my Instagram. So, you know, it just comes with the territory. But the rewards, you know, are wonderful. And I wouldn't have it any other way. And does anybody have any questions for me? Okay. This young lady right here, you can stand up, baby. This young lady said, what did I do after my mother told me I wasn't going to make it? I didn't speak to my mother for a few years because of that. It hurt me, but she was never really a nice mother to me. Okay, is this one on? Okay, this one's way, way better. Yeah, you know, it hurt me to the core, but I just didn't speak to her for a long time. I didn't want anyone, family or not, that wasn't going to support my dreams. So that's how I handled it. I just blocked her and a lot of other people that were negative out of my life. Go ahead. No, we haven't spoken in 9 years. Yeah, and I know that's hard for a lot of you kids to imagine, but you know, it's been a hard part of my life because this is someone that is supposed to love me and was supposed to care for me that was never supportive. So I had to make a conscious decision. I tried everything to get along and it just never worked out. So that's just part of my story. Okay, young lady in the blue jacket. I'm sorry, can you? Oh, hold on, he's gonna bring you the microphone.
How did it feel after you went on TV?
Oh man, amazing. It was life-changing, I'll tell you. Places that wouldn't let me in the door before, nightclubs and restaurants in the city that were like, oh, you know, no more people. They roll out the red carpet now. They all want to be my friend. But you know, it's a lot of fake love. But you know, it feels good because I accomplished what I set out to do. So that was the best feeling for me. Okay? I'm sorry?
Did you give your mom any backbone?
Did I give her any backbone?
Do you give your mom any backbone?
What do you mean? Did I give my mom back talk? No, not really. I was a good kid. It was just my mom wasn't a good mom. So. Okay, young man in the black shirt right here. Yeah, you. I mean, I'm not rich. I'm not on the Will Smith level by any measure, but I'm comfortable. And you know what? It's not even just about the money, guys. It's about doing something that I love, you know, and that I want to do. So the pay is just a bonus because I'm actually enjoying my work every day. This lady here, right here, the yellow. Oh, okay, go ahead. Back there. Okay, young lady in the navy blue. Yes, love the hair. Fabulous, darling. Yes.
You still respect your mother?
I'm sorry?
You still respect your mother?
Yes, I still respect my mother. She was the best mother that she could be. She was being the best parent that she knew how to be. I still love my mother, but it just, we don't get along, and that's just life. That's just how it is with us. I love her, and of course I respect her. She's my mother. She gave birth to me, but we don't get along. We'll just leave it at that. So, while you're back there, there's a young guy behind you. Yeah, with the white shirt.
Do you think you'll ever forgive her?
Yeah, I've already forgiven my mother because, you know what? They say when you don't forgive somebody, it's like, you know, you're carrying it around and it's poisoning you. It's not poisoning the other person, you know? So that would be something that would just be a detriment to me. Hold on, here's this guy in the black shirt. Mm-hmm. You guys are really interested in my mother. I'm gonna have to get my mother up here, huh? Hear her side of this.
Is it hard, the fact that you have to be on Love & Hip Hop with so many girls? Don't y'all fight?
Oh yeah, I mean, we've had our altercations. You know, there's a lot of negativity, but the show is called Love and Hip Hop, and it focuses on relationships. But the drama always comes. I don't personally, I'm too old to be over there fighting, honestly, even though I did get into an altercation. Y'all saw it. But I'm not proud of that, and that's not the way to handle things, honestly. The remainder of the show focused on my relationship. And, you know, the trials and tribulations, that's what the show is supposed to be about, honestly. Okay, who's next? This young lady here with the braids.
When did you know it was time to leave your small town and go to New York City?
Okay, that's a good question. It was time for me to leave when I knew I wasn't happy, that no amount of money, nothing could bring me happiness because I knew I still had a dream in my heart that I had not fulfilled. So, you know, I left when I was 29, which probably is very old to you guys, but I knew if I didn't leave when I left, it was gonna be now or never. And I left when I left, it was the right time.
Okay, you have to remain quiet so she can answer questions and take questions, etc., okay? So we have to keep it down.
So yeah, I knew it was time to leave because I just knew I had a dream inside of me that hadn't been fulfilled yet. Okay, this young lady here. And then we'll take two more after this. Oh boy. Uh-oh.
Did you forgive the person for love and hip hop?
You know, that's a good question. Which one? My boyfriend? Or no, it wasn't about forgiving. We just never saw each other. We just avoided each other. I think she moved to LA or something. I don't know. Like there was nothing to forgive. Okay, hold on, this young lady's been waiting for a while in the yellow.
Can I get
your autograph? Oh my gosh, you're so cute. You all can get pictures after. My handwriting is very sloppy. That was not my best subject in school. But we can take pictures afterwards, guys. Okay, one more good question besides that. That was a good question. Go ahead.
Did you ever try to get back to your mom or dad?
I'm sorry?
Did you ever try to contact or get back to your mom and dad?
Oh yeah, I did try to get in touch with my mother. I tried counseling. I tried a lot of things to make it work because of course, who doesn't want a relationship with their mother? Of course I wanted a mother. I wanted her to love me. I wanted to get along. But like I said, we pretty much tried everything and nothing really worked, so, you know, that's just, it's sad, but I miss her a lot, of course, but it's not a good situation, like I said, so, you know, and I'm still willing to try to work things out, probably. Okay, one last question. Hold on, this lady in the blue.
Was there any time that you felt like giving up or crying or stopping?
All the time, of course. There were times that I did give up and there were times that I did stop. But then I remembered, like, this is my one life. I have one life. And if I don't do it, I'm gonna be 80 years old looking back wishing I did. And then I'm really gonna be mad. So what was the worst thing that could have happened if I tried? I would have failed? Okay, I failed at a lot of things in life. I'm still here, I'm still breathing. You know, you can't give up. You gotta always try. You gotta find your dream, your gift, your talent, and be the best at it. I'm still, you know, I go to acting classes every Friday night because I'm perfecting my craft. Because there's competition out here. Any field that you choose to get into, whether it's business, sales, acting, the medical field, you have competition. You have to be the best at whatever you choose to do. Study, read, everything you can about that. Learn as much as you can because especially here in New York, you're swimming with sharks. I mean, there's so many people out here that want to take those jobs and that money. Everybody's fighting for a dollar, so you have to really be determined and focused to make it happen and stay on track. So no, giving up's just not an option. Okay, one last question and then we're done. Okay, this guy here, because he's been on it.
Remain quiet, please.
In this it says you have a younger daughter, right?
No. Oh. I have my chihuahua that's like my daughter. My dog, March Tiffany.
So you
had to go. Who wrote that? They put the baby in me? They talking that into existence already? I'm gonna be a mom this year, that means. I'd like to have a child. Okay guys, well you guys have been wonderful. We'll take pictures afterwards. Been a wonderful audience. Thank you so much for listening to me.